Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the economic slowdown in the economy. Now first of all we need to understand what the author wants to convey in this specific editorial. Now the author has written this editorial in order to delve deep in two dimensions. Now the first dimension is why there has been a downturn, and secondly he has focused on the suggestions that what actually needs to be done. So there are two aspects that we need to understand: why there has been a downturn, and secondly we need to understand how the economic revival can be brought in. Now before we understand these two aspects, we need to understand the market versus the state debate, because that will give us a better idea about why there has been a downturn in the Indian economy. Now when it comes to the market versus the state debate, M versus S debate, now this debate is about that the state don't have the capacity to provide services to the citizenry, and for that reason the market should actually come in and decide about what role it is going to play with respect to offering the services to the citizens. So the market is becoming a part of governance. Now this transcendental change, this paradigm of market versus state, actually began in year 1991 when India had retrusted with the economic reforms. So this was the first thing about the market. The market was accorded a lot of responsibility. Market was accorded the responsibility to provide the services, along with that also to be party to the goal of growth. Now this is very important. Market was asked that it should be party to this growth aspect, that it should actually be promoting growth in the economy. But of late, after 2008, what the world is witnessing is that there has been a decline and downturn in the economic growth rate globally. Now in order to arrest this downturn, in order to bring about a transformation and a change in the growth rate of the economy globally, what we have seen that there has been an intervention by the state. Now state was something that we had neglected about in 1990s, but of late again we are going back to the states, so that the states can act as a succor, states can act as a support system to the declining and the dwindling growth rate. So the biggest suggestion that has been made of late by Pillai Balakrishnan is about how we can arrest and contain the fall in the growth rate. This can be done if we will be investing lot in the reforms, and along with that the state should come forward and arrest the decline that is that currently we are witnessing. Now when it comes to the growth rate that any economy should be achieving, there are two inputs that actually propel this growth rate. Now the first aspect that propels the growth rate is the investment that is done by the public sector and as well as the private sector domestically, and secondly the investment that is done by the international players, that is in the form of FDI and FII. Now out of FDI and out of FII, foreign institutional investors, it is the FDI that is important. And in FDI again we have two subtypes. One is the green FDI, the other is the brown FDI. Now out of the green and the brown, which is most important, is the green FDI that is more important, because the green FDI, it is something that will be creating new employment opportunities, it will be creating new infrastructure, and it will be also creating the opportunities to create new products in the economy. But when it comes to the brown type of investment, FDI investment, it will not be creating these new things. Only there will be change in the ownership. So if we look at from the growth perspective point of view, what is more important is not only important that there should be FDI, but what type of distinctive FDI we are actually looking for. And the FDI that we are looking for, it should not be the brown FDI, rather it should be the green FDI. Now coming back to the second input, that is the investment done by the public and the private sector. Now of late, what we are seeing is a decline in the investment by the private sectors. And this has to do with the NPAs of the banks. This is the first thing. And secondly, it has to do with the web of the regulations with which the Indian economy is actually restricted with, like in the form of bankruptcy laws, like in the form of labor laws, and like in the form of restrictions by the various ministries ranging from environment to the health to the education, etc. So we have numerous restrictions placed by the ministries. So presently what we are having is there are two challenges that we are facing if we want to arrest this decline. The first is that we need to actually work against this NPA, non-performing assets. This will restore the health of the banks, and the banks, they act as a blood bank for the economy. Now, without restoring the blood bank of the economy, you cannot make the economy grow, you cannot make the economy work. So secondly, we actually need to work out in order to create effective environment for the foreign direct investment. Now, if we want to restore this growth rate, we really need to do investment. And currently, like, it will be difficult for the private sector to ask and invest at the earliest. The important decision should be taken by the public sector. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.